Trading Unlocked, and we're here with a Forex market breakdown for you today of the US-Canada currency cross. So before we get into that, we want to just go over our disclaimer real quick that just basically lets you know that this is for illustrative purposes and educational purposes, and that is it. So with that, let's get into the heart of the matter. Let's pull up our chart here, and we have the US-Canada currency cross. And what we have here is a daily chart, and you can see that over the past week and a half, there's been a very, very large break on the in the market. Now, what you can also see is that the recent high back up there around 135 half, down all the way down to below this 132.48 pivot. That's a rather extreme move that's happened over the last week and a half. In fact, that whole range encompasses all the trading that's been going on in that market for over upwards of 6 months. So quite the drop that we've seen in the U.S. dollar Canada. Now, I think that this big slide that you see is probably mostly accounted for from the U.S. dollar weakness that has come into the market over the past couple weeks, especially in some of the lesser majors. And it's more of just a corrective slide in the U.S. dollar. If you look at the U.S. dollar index, it's been riding highs. And this little turn back towards support, it was just probably more of a profit-taking move than anything. Markets don't go in straight lines. So the U.S. dollar was due for a pullback, which then obviously gains strength for the Canadian dollar. So let's take a look at these levels. So the low that was made just a couple sessions ago was a gap open lower that then ended up closing positive on the day and above the close of that prior day that was down on a very extreme break. So we have today's session, which is still higher and is hovering around this 132.86 directional pivot. I think that we're probably going to see over the next couple days a lot of gyrating around this level. I would key off of that low from a couple days ago as a risk level for any longs, especially whether you're very bullish or not too bullish and you just want to give it a shot. I would say definitely be careful about the momentum is to the downside, even though the market has been in a range trade to higher mode for a couple few months. Recently, we have this activity, which is bearish. It may just be a correction, and this may be one great bounce to buy into, but use proper money management techniques, and I would definitely use that low or that key support pivot as a risk level. I would be very leery of being long underneath any type of new move lows. The market may be in a bottoming process, but if it starts to hit support there, I think that that shows that there is continued dollar weakness. Now, that being said, I think that the U.S. Canada helped lead the charge against the U.S. dollar for a few weeks. So could this currency cross be showing signs of yet another turn against the current trend? And that may be happening right now, because in some of your other lesser majors, you have the U.S. dollar gaining strength again, as it is in the Canada here after an extreme sell-off. So that being said, there's a little bit of a divergence, which happened a few weeks ago when the market first turned and the bears got a hold of this U.S. dollar-Canada cross and started to hammer it. So the market may actually be coming through the same phase again, except in the opposite direction. And if that's the case, then there's a really good chance of the U.S. dollar Canada reaching that 133.56 upside key resistance pivot. Initially, I think that you would probably see the market come off of that and maybe digest the recent market action, because if the bulls can get a rally up to there, especially over the next few sessions into next week, that would be quite a volatile range of motion for this currency cross over the last, which would be at that point 3 weeks of trading, which is, it's not uncommon for this market to gyrate. If you look at the daily charts, it hits the highs and lows of the previous days a lot, where it's range trading around in those areas. So you'll have an extreme up day, maybe another up day, and then you have a really harsh sell-off, followed by then another huge rally back up within that range, and then vice versa, and chopping around before it ends up making newer move highs or newer move lows. In recent history, it's been more newer move highs. Now we have the situation where we've made new lows. So it's an interesting situation, too, because on the daily chart, you have that recent high from a couple weeks ago, and now this new low, which, because of their extremes, is probably going to set the range. for the next couple of months, actually. Due to all the news, you have the G20 summit coming up in another week and a half, which will weigh heavy on the dollar. And I think that you're starting to see some dollar strength again because of some of the positive turn of events with the Mexican peso, or excuse me, the U.S.-Mexican tariff disputes. And I think that also impacts the U.S. dollar-Canada trade as well because of all the manufacturing and the import-exporting between the three countries, Mexico, Canada, and the United States. So that being said, I think that your odds are in your favor right now of being slightly bullish, even though the short-term trend is obviously down. But right now it seems like the support is holding. And especially with that kind of buying pressure, to set a low like that and bounce back, it takes a lot of buying. And that's, for me, I would have to say that indicates that that is definitely a short, well, it's obviously a short-term low for the past couple of days, but I think that it will hold. And even if the market turns back on support for a sell-off, just keep watch that key support level at 132.48. If the market stays above that, then you may see a reversal of fortune again, which then if it makes a run at the directional pivot again, I think you will see a surge that will probably end up being a rally over a couple of sessions in upwards of maybe a week and a half that'll take the market back up towards that 133.56 pivot area. So that being said, overall, let's take into account and remember that the short-term trend is down, so be very careful with your longs and buying into it. Pick your points and use smart risk management principles. And if you're short, or if you're a bearer for this market, I would look to find selling opportunities. I think that right now, if you are not already short and working it, I think that you might be selling it in the hole, and that's something you don't want to do, because for the way this market stopped after that extreme sell-off, that tells me that the U.S. dollar is not, it was more of a corrective slide. Even if the market is turning, it's going to take weeks to months for that to happen because of all the news. Like I said, reminding yourself always of this G20 meeting coming up over the next week and a half. It's a summertime market, and there's some really key topics that are going to be covered. They always talk about economic and political things. But right now, this tariff thing weighs really heavy, and we know that the U.S. has made pretty much the message clear to China that at that meeting, they want to come to the table on some stuff and actually get something done, which would also be help the world stage because all the leaders are there present, and it would be nice to see all the children come to the table and behave nicely, which would benefit pretty much everybody, I would think. But if not, then we know that we can expect more of the same. And also the Chinese tariff thing, I think this will be a very good indication of how long it will take to hash things out. If the Chinese do not come to some sort of positive agreements with the United States at this G20 meeting, then I think what you're really seeing is that China is holding out for the elections. They are going to ride this tariff war out and wait for the next election to find out if there's a turnover in leadership, because then if there is, they know they'll get more of the same, and then this whole thing will just be nothing but a bump for them. If not, then they will then obviously, if there is not a turnover in U.S. leadership in a year from now, then you will probably definitely start to see them bargain and come to the table with the United States. We know from 2008 that when the U.S. economy came to a grinding halt after a year and a half of that, that the whole Chinese economy was ready to collapse and implode. Right now, because of what's going on with the tariff wars, Asia is exploding. Even the Chinese are using other countries and counterfeiting labels made in China to made in Vietnam and other countries just to get their goods out of their country. So that means that the Chinese are scrambling. If they have to put someone else's made in label on their products just to try and get them into the U.S., that means they are definitely loaded with inventory and worried about what to do. And the reality is that the Chinese economy does rely on the U.S. consumer. The U.S. consumer does not rely on the Chinese economy. They just rely on supply, which definitely can be made for, you know, it's already showing. You have Vietnam, whose GDP is exploding. It's going all throughout Singapore and Korea and other countries. Japan is booming now. I mean, not necessarily booming, but there is an uptick in their economy because markets will correct. And, you know, the thing is that even if there is a deal, companies now are getting products that they need made better than in China for the same price or less. So why would they go back to China and have more of the same? So I think that we'll see what happens. But if the G20 meeting doesn't have any type of bearing that's going to be favorable towards that agreement, then I would say that the U.S. dollar, Canada trade, and many of the other currencies are going to lock into some ranges where it's because it's going to be a stalemate. And then it will be driven more on if there is any major U.S. dollar reasons to drive these markets. Like if, for instance, we have economic numbers over the next few days that are pretty critical towards interest rates and currencies. So if there's any major shifts in those kinds of numbers, then I would say you would start to see some adverse trends that could develop. But otherwise, I think we're going to start to set some wide ranges because we need to get clarity on what's going to happen with global trade. So we'll see what happens in the next couple of weeks. But for a wrap up for today's little market breakdown of the U.S.-Canada, let's just take a look at it one last time. So if you're a bull, I would say use that recent low from a few sessions ago or that 132.48 pivot to buy against or use as your risk level to get out of any longs. It's a situation where every long should be probably in a week-long situation here because if the market does take out that low, it's pretty bearish. And definitely your target would be that 133.56 level. And if you're bearish, I would say look for opportunities to sell. I'm not that I'm overly bullish, but I think that you're going to be very choppy to the downside if there's any opportunities there. So with that being said, I want to thank you very much for listening to this market breakdown. We hope you enjoyed the analysis. And if you did, and if you're interested in more of where I get my theories and ideas from, you can learn all about it in a book that I wrote, High Probable Japanese Candlestick Patterns. It's available on Kindle and paperback on Amazon. And you can learn in that book how to utilize the best buy and sell patterns used for over 400 years to give yourself a competitive edge against the markets. And it also can be used in Forex, futures, options, stock equity markets, and ETFs, and all kinds of other markets. And as well as you can use it for correlation trades, where you may not be a currency trader, but what happens in the currencies affects other markets and even ETFs and other type of things like that. So if you're an equity trader that just doesn't really trade the currencies, you know, there's ways that you can capitalize on these types of moves as well. So as well as other things, it's what are covered in the book. So with that, thank you very much. And please like, follow, and share this the links to this on Twitch. And help us to build up our following so we can get some more regular content and also scheduled content for you. And also we have, for the High Probable Japanese Candlestick Patterns book, we have some patterns that we will be producing some lesson videos for you in the not too distant future. Thank you very much. You have a great day and good luck with all your trading. Take care.